Hey guys, my name is Trip Lee. Welcome to Senior Shoreline Week. I'm so pumped that you guys are here. I know high school can be a time full of highs and lows, but one thing that always remains the same is God's love and provision for us. And so the seniors have decided to create this series called Note to Self, where we share experiences and encouragement from our high school career that we wish we would have known going in. I'm super excited that you guys could be a part of this, and I hope y'all are encouraged by what we have to share.
Note to self, clean the living room. Do the things you don't want to do, maybe for that week.
Hey guys, my name is Clara. High school can be a time marked by unforgettable memories and challenging seasons. If I had the ability to write a note to myself at a time in high school when I needed it the most, here's what my note to self would say. I know friendships are starting to fade and it feels like you are alone. I know you are angry with the Lord because you have another athletic injury. I know you are feeling apathetic in your faith and don't know what to do. It will take time for things to get better, so please be patient. The Lord has a bigger plan for those friendships than you can see now, but He will give you community. Fighting the change the Lord is placing in your life will only leave you hurting longer. I pray you learn from James 1, 2 through 4. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. A relationship with the Lord takes work. Your apathy is not going to go away on its own. Being vulnerable and trusting your small group is not a sign of weakness, but of obedience. Injuries have been placed in your life to help you see the true value of a relationship with Him. I know there are a lot of unknowns right now, but things will get better. You will learn that though more hurts will come, you will not be alone because the Lord is your rock and He has placed community around you in ways you cannot see yet. Trust in His plan and be open to these relationships. Allow community to do life with you and be a part of your story, and new relationships will form, new memories will be made, and the Lord will be glorified. Spend some time meditating on Proverbs 24:6. If you can relate to my story, my encouragement to you would be that though tough trials will come, the Lord is with you, His timing is perfect, and He is constantly working. You are not alone. Don't run from the gift of godly community. My prayer is that God's work in my life would lead you to trust Him more with yours. Thank you.
Hey guys, my name is Cooper Brown, and as my senior year is closing up, it's just been a really good time of reflection. And so I actually wrote a letter to my ninth grade self, just giving some advice on what I would change about my years in high school. Hey Coop, you're about to start your first year of high school, and some exciting times are ahead. You finally get to go to homecoming with that girl you like. You'll even get a chance to play underneath the Friday night lights. There are so many great times ahead of you, but along with these great times will come a real struggle, idolatry. You would never call it that because you've been raised in the church, and obviously you would never worship anything besides God. However, despite your mouth constantly praising God, your heart is far from Him. You're finding your worth in temporary achievements, and it's stripping you of your joy. No perfect game, no perfect grade, not even finding that perfect girl will fill that need in your heart. As your year goes on, you'll notice every time you try to find life in worldly things, you end up left in disappointment. You'll never be cool enough, strong enough, or smart enough to be satisfied. You always want more. So stop pretending like you have it all figured out, and let this realization move your heart towards God. He has always been there, waiting right by your side, patiently but eagerly calling you to Him. You won't find life in high school achievements, but in God you'll find purpose, peace, and unexplainable joy. Once you begin to let God in, the next faithful step is to let others in as well. God made us to live in constant community with others. I know this means going outside your comfort zone, but believe it or not, God's plan for your life is a lot better than yours. Being willing to be real with your brothers in Christ is super important. If you keep waiting for someone else in your small group to step up, you'll continue to wait for years to come. Rely on God's strength and be the first one to be open and honest with your struggles. In time, others will follow your example. Just be faithful and let God take care of the rest. If you can relate to my story or find yourself in a similar situation, my encouragement to you would be, first, stop trying to find your worth in worthless things. God has called us to be His sons and daughters. A relationship with Him, our true Father, is worth immensely more than anything the world can offer. Secondly, God never meant for us to endure the brokenness of this world alone. Join up with other believers, encouraging and rebuking each other daily, and run wholeheartedly after the Father. My prayer is that God's work in my life would lead you to trust Him more with your life. So thank you for letting me share my story.
Howdy y'all, my name is Parker Newton. Here's what my note to self would say. To the girl I was freshman year, I want you to know that your priorities do not have to revolve around the opinion of others. You're created to be who the Lord says you are ought to be, not who you believe others to say you are. You've built your life on how others view, think, and want you to be. I encourage you deeply to understand the truth that He created you to be yourself, serving a purpose that is yet to be fulfilled because you feel so trapped in pleasing others. Galatians 1:10 says, "For am I now seeking the approval of man or of God? Or am I trying to please man? If I were still trying to please man, I would not be a servant of Christ." To the girl I was sophomore year, do not give in to the lie that you are unworthy and undeserving of life. You feel so entangled in the lie that you can never be pretty enough, smart enough, athletic enough, and talented enough to be placed on this earth. That is not true. God loves and deems you worthy. He carefully knitted you in your mother's womb, Psalm 139:13, planned the life ahead of you, and walks with you to this day through the many different struggles and seasons because He loves you. Do not give taking your own life another thought, for He has seen your pain and knows that you are His child, loving you so much that He would give His Son to die for your sake. To the girl I was junior year, be joyous in that you have accepted Christ into your life. You have found the life that is fruitful, no longer anxious about the plans ahead, for you now know that they are held within the hands of the Lord, Jeremiah 29:11. You have been surrounded by friends that are here for you, encouraging you deeper into His love and wanting you to better understand His word. However, know that even if you are surrounded by the Lord, seasons will come in which you will be tempted to revert back to your old ways, wanting you to believe the lies placed in your mind by evil. Stay firm in your faith, for you now have seen that you are able to do anything with the Lord by your side. I leave you the truth that is 2 Corinthians 5:17, which says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come." If you can relate to my story or ever find yourself in a similar situation, my encouragement to you would be, wherever you may go from here, know that you are not who others say you are, but who God says you are. Remember that you are loved beyond measure.
Hi guys, my name's Raleigh.
And I'm Olivia, and we love to wrap this time up by responding in worship, so we're gonna sing "Though You Slay Me."
Say you do it.